Yo, yo, what up, C10 Nation? This is Ronnie from C10 Talk. C10 Talk is one of those podcast things. We talk C10 trucks, tech, and people. That's right, people. Because it's the people that make the scene so rad-ass. The trucks are cool, but the people are cooler. You can check out the podcast on iTunes, Spotify, Pandora, iHeartRadio, C10Talk.com, and anywhere else you listen to your favorite podcasts. Thanks for checking out our latest video and being part of the C10 Nation.
Get down, wrap up. The man, the myth, the legend, my brother, Delmo. We got a chance to stop by the shop and check out this, she's one bad bitch. And we got to see it when it was like the chassis, and I mean, it was in a whole different kind of segment. This is your era, this is your style.
Are you nervous talking to me?
No.
You seem a little nervous.
No.
Oh, okay, good.
Are you nervous?
No, I'm fine, carry on.
Now I'm nervous about being nervous. No, I'm not nervous. I love the paint, I love the style, and I love the, you know, this era for you is really kind of, for me, I love to see you build these kind of trucks.
Yeah, so from the Forum days, I think Dino and I kind of like really started messing with these 60s style trucks.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they have the best lines. And in black, like this one with the trim, I think you just can't do any better, honestly.
On this truck with the lines, I feel like 4.6, it's like, okay, it's kind of cool. But the line is better and the truck is better the lower you go with these trucks.
True.
And once you get as low as you can go, that's where these trucks and your style, and we just interviewed Levi from Hammer Fab, same. The lower you go with these trucks, they just look that much better.
It really, really does. And I'm a sucker for a little bit of rake, so I don't like to dump the back on the ground, but yeah, they look amazing low. Because they have real low wheel wells to begin with, so they just tend to tuck a wheel a lot better than most, so.
Okay, so how about the this build? How'd it come across? How'd the color? What did the, you know, does the builder say, be Delmo?
Yeah, it was great. The customer like kind of let me do whatever I wanted. He had a couple things black. You know, the wife wanted some orange in the interior. Other than that, you know, he wanted some cool spoky black wheels and big power. So we did a Whipple and he let me just keep it clean, Delmo style. No Lambo doors or funky mini truck stuff. But so it's kind of a hot rod truck that I would probably build if I were to build one for myself.
Paint is just absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, it's a base coat black, or base clear black that's like almost impossible to make nice, but the guys up in Prescott did a real good job making it straight and buffed it out, and I've been cleaning it all weekend. And
when you think about the style of these trucks all came with a fawn interior.
Yeah.
Do you ever think about changing that up, or what's your go-to?
Yeah, so on this one we did like a gunmetal gray and then put some satin clear over it, so it kind of looks like that factory sheen, but it's more of a I think it helps the black being just like a matte gray. So I didn't want to do the gray in the insert. I think the truck just looks cleaner with the black. Typically, you know, you'll see that insert painted ivory white,
yeah,
or whatever. So we just kind of left it alone and did our typical inner fenders in the front, Whipple LS3 with a big camshaft and those big 24x10 or 15s.
So. That Del recipe, you've got the Del recipe down. It's a winning recipe. It's an oatmeal cookie, right? We love it. We love to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Anything within your recipe that was a struggle on this?
Not really. I mean, it was a pretty standard build. I've built so many of this style truck, especially with the inner fenders. La Fonda, you remember from 2015?
Yeah.
Had the same wheels and tires, so it was a real kind of just doing it over, but in black. So with black, you know, you have to make sure everything's a little nicer, but basically the same truck.
Do you struggle with that when you think about La Fonda, going back to La Fonda in 2015? You guys played with the two-sided wheel combo,
yeah,
which was fun. Do you, as a guy, when you look at a build and you work with an owner or a guy who's, you know, saying, hey, I want you to build me a truck, Dale, do you struggle with wheels combo setup at all?
Like,
seems the hardest part.
All the time. I think wheels can make or break anything, and so you have to be real careful. These wheels are a little out of my wheelhouse, but they...
See what you did there?
Yeah, but they look great. Everybody loved them in 2015, so we're like, what the hell? Let's see what they look like on a black truck. And I think they suit this better than they did La Fonda. And La Fonda ended up going with the smoothies anyway, which was a home run for that truck. So I think this turned out exactly how I would have built it for myself.
Yeah. What do you think about the style within the trucks, especially, I mean, as we're sitting here, there's some of these 60 to 66 style trucks are leaving, but when people are doing a lot of the gold and the bronze on the wheels, do you dig that style?
Yeah, I do. I dig it. I would never do it personally, but I'd like to look at it. Like it's the new fad, right?
Yeah.
So for me, I like to have my stuff timeless, and that stuff will come and go. Like
yeah.
You're not gonna see that in a year or two, but it's cool. I dig it.
Well, one of the things you said to me 5 years ago when we interviewed you on the pod is I remember you saying, hey, if a Dell build goes in a shop, a shed, a backyard garage, and somebody pulls it out 20, 25 years later,
yeah.
It'll still be in style.
Yes, it will. And there's nothing wrong with dating something. Like if you and I were to find a barn find OBS with a set of like tri-fans on it,
yeah.
We would know exactly what year that came from.
Yeah.
So I think maybe like these copper wheels and some of the stuff you're seeing now, that will date it to a certain era.
Yeah.
But I think now it just goes quicker. I think the fads come and go a lot faster now.
Yeah.
So I think building something that will just remain timeless is cool whenever is more important, to me at least.
Yeah. Well, so. Big power, right stance, right wheel, it's Dell style. Thank you, brother.
Thanks, man.
Thanks.
Good to see you.